And you are watching my channel Book Junction. So this video has to be one of the most highly requested videos over the time because a lot of you guys wanted me to talk about Khalid Hosseini books. So finally it's time that I actually talk about him and his books. Now let's get started. I will not waste any more time. I have read 3 books by him: The Kite Runner, A Thousand Splendid Suns, and The Mountains Echoed. And out of all these 3 books, I have loved The Kite Runner and The Thousand Splendid Suns, but I did not like the third one, maybe because of all the pressure and everything, he could not deliver as good a book as he did previously. So that's completely okay, it happens. Now when I say Afghanistan, what comes to your mind instantly? For me, it always used to be war, violence, destruction. But after reading Khalid Hosseini's books, I have actually completely changed my perspective towards Afghanistan. So Khalid Hosseini's books are all about the people of Afghanistan, their stories, their people, their social structure, and everything related to Afghanistan. So for us, these places are war zones, but for so many people, these places are their homes. And whenever we talk about home, we have memories, we have all these relationships that we share with the people who live in those places. So Khalid Hosseini tries to present in front of us the stories of Afghanistan, and that's exactly the theme of his books. Now let's start with The Kite Runner. The Kite Runner is the story of Amir and Hassan. Amir is a Pashtun and Hassan is a Hazara. Pashtuns are upper class and Hazaras belong to the lower category in the social construct of Afghanistan. Now honestly, it's a rarity when you find a book that talks about male friendship the way Kite Runner does. So Kite Runner is basically all about the friendship of Amir and Hassan and whatever happens between them. So because of Amir's cowardice, a lot of things happen between the two, but Hassan is the one who stays loyal to him no matter what. And we also get to read a lot about vulnerability. So between Amir and Hassan, Hassan is the one who is more vulnerable, who is more prone to crying, who is more sensitive, I would say. And Amir is the one who is more conscious about his prestige, his ego, and his image around people. So Amir is extremely aware of his standing in the society. So he always tries to protect it, and that in turn shows you his insecurities. But when it comes to Hassan, we see his undying, relentless love towards Amir. His friendship for Amir is absolutely unconditional, and he can go to whatever extent it requires for him to prove his friendship to him and just to be loyal to Amir. And this in turn gives us this lesson that vulnerability and sensitivity, these two things are powerful emotions. These make you a better human being. That's exactly what we saw with Hassan. He was extremely vulnerable. He was always so emotional. He was sensitive towards Amir, but he was also extremely courageous. He had strength. He was strong enough to always stand up for Amir, to always be there for him. But this was not the case with Amir. Amir was always conscious about himself. He was always conscious about how he looked in the society. And he was sort of embarrassed about his friendship with a Hazara boy. And that also made him very weak in itself. And we also see Amir's relationship with his father. His father wants him to become strong. His father wants him to not be a coward. But at the end of the day, Amir does all the things that are too cowardly. So the idea that strength is always something that stands beside being uptight and not sensitive, not emotional, that's completely rubbish. And that's exactly what the book tries to explain to people. I don't know if it was a conscious decision from the side of Khalid Hosseini to show it to us, but this is something that I definitely took away from the book. Now let's talk about A Thousand Splendid Suns. A Thousand Splendid Suns is about two women, Maryam and Leila. Now Leila was born a generation after Maryam, so obviously there was a huge age difference between the two. And that's why we see a motherly figure in Maryam towards Leila. But that's not how it was from the beginning. So first we get to see Maryam's childhood and her story. Then we get to read about Leila's childhood and her story, and then because of certain things their lives collide, they intersect and they come together. So again, in this book there is also a huge difference in the way the two women were brought up. Maryam was born in an underprivileged family where she did not get her father's love as much as she would want to, because her father had a completely another family. So that's why she had to go through a lot of harassment in the society, and she did not get the love she deserved. And that's how she grew up, and eventually she was married to a man who was abusive towards her and who was manipulative, and that was the life that she accepted for herself. But on the other hand, Leila was born in a family that was rich, that had their own privileges, and Leila was an educated woman. Whenever a place turns into a war zone, there are two communities that are completely destroyed. One, children; two, women. Whenever something bad happens, women and children go through the absolute worst. And that's why whenever I see anyone talking about war in casual sense, I'm like, why don't you go and read Khalid Hosseini books? Because you really need to, because you don't understand what war does to people's life, what war does to places. The places that were once home to people turn into debris, and that is just so sad. And after reading both the books, I was completely devastated. Now there is this one question that I get a lot: which one is my favorite, The Kite Runner or A Thousand Splendid Suns? Honestly, it's very difficult to say, and if I have to give stars, I will give both the books 5 stars without any doubts. Very rarely do we get to read about male friendship as beautiful as it's portrayed in The Kite Runner, and that's why I feel like a lot of people will say that The Kite Runner is much more closer to their heart, because we don't read about those issues that are dealt in The Kite Runner. And I don't want to give out any spoilers, but just let me tell you that Kite Runner is one of the most heartbreaking books ever. If you want to cry, read this book. And I feel like, yes, that book really hits home. So both the books are just equally good, but since Kite Runner explores something extremely rare, that's why I feel like it's much more closer to my heart. But nonetheless, both the books need to be read by everyone, and I recommend both the books equally. Now let's talk a little bit about the writing style. I feel like Khalid Hosseini's writing style is exceptionally lyrical, but it feels like a river when you read the book. The story just flows. So in one word, Khalid Hosseini's writing style is exquisite, and that too without being too difficult or complex. Alright, so that was all for today's video. I really hope that you all enjoyed this video and found it valuable. If you did, then definitely like, share and subscribe to my channel. It will mean a lot to me. And also click on the bell icon so you are updated with all the instant notifications. And I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.